Hello, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com, bringing you the second in our series of videos on the U.S. election impacting markets. In this case, we'll be looking over the course of decades and in some cases centuries of economic data to determine how can the U.S. election impact the stock market, with a focus on the U.S. stock market and the S&P 500 in particular. Let's get into it. Overall, we've totaled up the performance of the S&P 500 under different presidents over the last 50 or so years. And the big takeaway from this chart, at least for me, is that the stock market usually rises over longer periods of time, like 4 or 8 years. And you can see this is happening regardless of whether there's Democrats or Republicans in office. If you drill down into the data, you'll see that on average, the S&P 500 has risen more under Democratic presidents than Republican, maybe a counterintuitive finding for some. But I think that's more likely to be noise. Ultimately, with all of this analysis, we're looking at a relatively small sample size. Even going back decades and decades here, we're only capturing about 8 to 10 distinct presidencies. And it's worth noting that the president, just one person, cannot influence policy, cannot drive policy, I should say, across the entire U.S., much less the entire world. We have to look at the makeup of Congress as well, and just the general economic environment that is independent of the president. So if we look at that performance, this is what I mentioned on the last slide, we can see actually, regardless of Democratic or Republican presidents, the performance of the stock market has actually been best with a divided Congress, which is to say the Democrats or Republicans control the House of Representatives and the other party controls the Senate. Under this type of setup, it can be difficult to pass more progressive, more extreme types of policies. And as a result, we tend to get more of a status quo environment, which traders seem to like. So do keep an eye not just on who wins at the top of the ticket, but also the makeup of the Senate and the House of Representatives. And the last slide I want to touch on here talks on the 4-year presidential cycle. And this is actually going back almost 200 years now to 1833, where we've generally seen middling performance in the first and second year of a president's tenure. But then in the pre-election year, the thesis is that they're spending a lot of money, injecting money into the economy so that it's strong, so that they or their party is more likely to get reelected. That's where we see the really strong performance, usually in the third year of a presidential cycle. And that does carry over to an extent into the election year where we are as I'm speaking. Keep this in mind from a longer term perspective. It is worth noting, however, that the impact, the magnitude of these moves has started to fade. They've started to normalize as this has become more widely known. So like many things in markets, history can be a guide, but it's not necessarily a guarantee to what's going to happen in the future. If you found this video interesting, please do check out the guide in the description below. We dive into more detail about how the presidential election can impact the stock market, and we also touch on the potential impact on gold and the US dollar. Thanks for your time and best of luck with your trading.